सो लास्ट टाइम हमने फंक्शन शुरू किया था और सबसे पहली चीज जो हमने डिस्कस की थी भाई फंक्शन होता क्या है वो आपको बताया था है ना। फंक्शन को आप एज ए मशीन समझ सकते हैं और मशीन एक स्पेसिफिक टाइप की है जहां पे आप उसको कुछ इनपुट देते हैं और वो कुछ आउटपुट आपको देगी। ठीक है, तो हमारी जो मशीन है वो इस तरीके की है। तो फंक्शन क्या है, इनपुट भी फिक्स होंगी और आउटपुट भी फिक्स होंगी। तो डिपेंडिंग ऑन द काइंड ऑफ फंक्शन और लेट्स से काइंड ऑफ मशीन, आपको इनपुट्स भी अलग अलग हो सकती हैं और आउटपुट्स भी अलग अलग हो सकती हैं, और उन्हीं इनपुट्स को बेसिकली वी कॉल एज डोमेन एंड जो आउटपुट से वो बेसिकली आपकी रेंज होती है। ओके, सो आई होप दिस इज क्लियर। तो लेट्स मूव टू द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट्स जो हमने कर रहे थे वहीं से आगे ही आपको नोट करना है बेसिकली। सो लिख लीजिए एक पॉइंट, अ पॉलीनोमियल ऑफ डिग्री ऑड हैज इट्स रेंज माइनस इंफिनिटी टू इंफिनिटी बट a polynomial of degree even has a range which is always a subset of R, ठीक है, subset of R। इसको आप सिंपली ऐसे समझ सकते हैं, देखो मान लीजिए आपको y is equal to x का ग्राफ बनाना है, ठीक है, y is equal to x का ग्राफ आपको बहुत अच्छे से पता है, y is equal to x plus 1 का ग्राफ आप बना सकते हैं, ये सब आप 9th क्लास में भी कर चुके हैं, 11th में तो किया ही है ना। सो दिस इज योर y is equal to x। अब आप देखिए इस केस में रेंज क्या है, ये कहीं तक भी जा सकता है, जितनी वैल्यूज आप एक्स को देते चले जाओगे प्लस इंफिनिटी तक उतना वाई बनता चला जाएगा, और वैसे ही आप नेगेटिव इंफिनिटी तक देते चले जाओगे सो यू विल गेट दी नेगेटिव इंफिनिटी आल्सो। सो इसका जो रेंज हो गया वो क्या हो गया, माइनस इंफिनिटी से प्लस इंफिनिटी तक हो गया। सिमिलरली अभी आपने क्लास 11th में जब आप आए थे तो आपने क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशंस पढ़ी थी, इनफैक्ट जिन लोगों ने 10th में भी पढ़ा है मुझसे उनको वहां पे भी बताया था मैंने कि भाई आपको क्वाड्रेटिक का ग्राफ कैसा होता था, भाई कुछ ऐसा होता था है ना, कुछ ऐसा होता था, ये सब ग्राफ्स आपको पता है। तो अभी हो कह रहा था या तो यहां पे फिक्स हो गया था है ना, और या यहां पे फिक्स हो गया था, तो सिचुएशन आपकी क्या बन रही थी, सिचुएशन हमेशा ये बन रही थी कि एक साइड तो ये या तो पॉजिटिव इंफिनिटी तक इधर पहुंच रहा था और यहां पे मिक फिक्स हो गया था नीचे लोअर पॉइंट है ना, और लोअर रेंज फिक्स हो गई थी, यहां पे क्या हुआ, यहां पे इस वाले ग्राफ में अपर रेंज फिक्स हो गई इसकी और लोअर फिर माइनस इंफिनिटी तक पहुंच रहा है। तो इवन वाले, इवन डिग्री वाले पॉलिनोमियल में हमेशा ऐसा होगा कि आपकी जो और रेंज होगी वो सबसेट ऑफ आर होगी, इसीलिए मैंने आपसे ये बात लिखाई भी। देखो लिखने का पर्पज ये है कि भाई आपको चीजें याद रहनी चाहिए, इसीलिए लिखा रहा हूं है ना, और आप नोट करेंगे जब आपके क्वेश्चन होंगे, व्हेन यू रिमेंबर ऑल दीज थिंग्स सो यू विल बी एबल टू डू देम एज वेल, राइट। सो ओके नाउ राइट another heading एल्जेब्रिक फंक्शंस, ठीक है। एल्जेब्रिक फंक्शंस, अगर आप एल्जेब्रिक ऑपरेशंस के थ्रू कुछ फंक्शंस को अगर आप ऐड सब्ट्रैक्ट कर सकें तो वो क्या होगा, एल्जेब्रिक फंक्शंस हो जाएंगे। फॉर एग्जांपल आपके रूट एक्स प्लस वन अपॉन एक्स, ये आपका एक एल्जेब्रिक फंक्शन होगा। एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस टू एक्स माइनस वन, ये सब भी एल्जेब्रिक फंक्शंस होंगे। खैर एनीवे यू डोंट हैव टू क्रैम ऑल दीज थिंग्स बिकॉज नोबडी इज गोइंग टू आस्क यू कि व्हाट इज एन एल्जेब्रिक फंक्शन। द ओनली थिंग इज यू शुड बी एबल टू डू क्वेश्चंस बेस्ड ऑन देम। सो दीज आर जस्ट थिंग्स व्हिच यू should have in your mind, okay, acha, we know what an algebraic function is. And you can put down a note, okay, here, all polynomials, poly likh raha hu main, are algebraic but not the converse. फंक्शंस, ये नोट वन हो गया, इसको नोट टू कर लें। फंक्शंस विच आर नॉट एल्जेब्रिक आर कॉल्ड ट्रांसेंडेंटल फंक्शंस। जो फंक्शंस विच आर नॉट एल्जेब्रिक आर ट्रांसेंडेंटल फंक्शंस। फॉर एग्जाम्पल साइन एक्स, ई टू द पावर एक्स, कॉस एक्स, दीज आर ऑल ट्रांसेंडेंटल फंक्शंस। बट एज आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू, नोबडी इज गोइंग टू आस्क दिस डेफिनेशन, ओके टेल अस वेदर दिस इज एल्जेब्रिक फंक्शन और अ transcendental function. So just don't worry about this. I'm just telling you this because if someday you hear this word, okay, you know, okay, what exactly are we talking about? Okay. Now is fractional or rational function. Functions of the form y is equal to fx is equal to gx over hx, right? So this kind of functions, and again, as you can easily see that hx should not be equal to zero. This kind of functions will be known as fractional or rational functions. Chaliye ji, ab now we are going to start with some important things which you must concentrate highly on, right? First is, I hope you have done it in class 11th as well, but we will do them again. Exponential function, यहां से एक्चुअली आपका जो है खेल शुरू होने वाला है, ठीक है। और वी विल डू देम, वी विल डू अ लॉट ऑफ क्वेश्चंस ऑन दीज फंक्शंस, स्पेशली डोमेन एंड रेंज। द रीजन इज इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड दीज डोमेन्स एंड रेंज, इट विल बी अ बेसिस फॉर योर कैलकुलस। So please do concentrate. A function fx is equal to a to the power x, a greater than 0, a not 1, x belonging to R is called exponential function. Okay, Nowadays, you must be hearing of this word that corona is spreading in exponential way, yeah, or exponentially. So this is what exactly they are talking about, how it will move. You will see, you can easily make out from the graph of this. So how, if we do not control this situation, if we do not stay at homes, how bad the situation can happen. And we have seen this in case of Italy. We have seen this in case of US. Okay. Can you make a graph of, let's say, y is equal to 2 to the power x? You have done it in class 9th. We have done it in class 10th. Probably. Gurpreet, can you please send a message? So, if some of you might have forgotten how we used to make a table for this, okay, this is xy, then you put different values of x, and then you get different values of y. Okay, so let's start. Let's put x is equal to 0. So the moment I put, this becomes 2 to the power 0, and 2 to the power 0 is 1. If I put 1 in place of x, I get 2. If I put 2, I get 4. Now you can see how quickly it's going to go up, right? This will become 2 to the power 3, that means 8, and so on. If I put infinity here, this will immediately reach to plus infinity. Let's say I put minus 1, so that would be 2 to the power minus 1, that means 1 over 2. So this is 1 over 2. If I put minus 2, this will give me 1 over 4. And similarly, if I put minus infinity, this will give me zero. Not minus infinity, this will give me zero. So if I make a graph of this, how will it look like? This will look like this, okay? And what this point would be? This point would be 0, 1. And rest you can always plot. So this is the graph of 2 to the power x. If we generalize it, we can always say that this is the graph of y is equal to a to the power x. You can change axis values of x and you will get different values of, right? So for example, we were talking about the exponent. Let's say we put x is equal to 10. That means 2 to the power 10. What will be the value? 1024. If I put x is equal to 11, this will be 2 to the power 11, and the answer would be 2048. Just doubled by increasing just one value of x. So this is how this exponent works. You will, when you grow up and you go to businesses or you go to some jobs, you will see this exponent will be discussed quite a lot there. Oh, every company, every person, every entrepreneur wants an exponential growth in the money that they want to make, right? So this is how it will look. So this is the graph, right? Now from this graph, can we say what is the domain of this? Can you please send me the messages about the domain of this and of course the range of this? Please just write this. What is domain and what is range of this? ओके, होल नंबर इज डोमेन. अमर्त सेज होल नंबर, दैट मीन्स अमर्त यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट होल नंबर्स. व्हाट अबाउट अदर्स? जानवी सेज डोमेन इज आर एंड रेंज इज आर. Amart says real numbers is domain. Yes, Amart, now you have got it correct. Because this x-axis, this whole x-axis is your domain. And this whole y-axis is your range. So domain is what? R. What is range? Tell me, what is range? Think about range. Just see from here. What are the values here in this part? That means first and second quadrant. Aren't they all positive? So what should be the range? R plus. There is nothing in this negative part. Yes, Janvi, got it right now. What if I take a graph for half? Let's say A is, because when I wrote this definition, we said A is greater than zero. And A is not equal to 1. So there could be a possibility that A is, let's say, half. What will be the graph for this? You can make this graph as well. That means you will have to make half to the power x. So start substituting values. Do it yourself, please, for some values and you will see. Let's say if I put x is equal to 0, I will get again 1. If I put x is equal to 1, I will get 1 by 2. If I put x is equal to 2, I get 1 by 4. And if I put infinity, so I will get 0 plus. Okay. If I, let's say, put minus 1, what will I get? Half to the power minus 1. That means I will get 2. If I put minus 2, I will get 4. And if I get minus infinity, I will get plus infinity. So this is how you can make the graph of half of x, right? So this graph will look like something right. You will keep on increasing it, it will go on going down, 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 and down. Okay. And this point would be again 0, 1. So if I put this value, let's say this graph here as well, so something like this will be visible. Okay, so this would be the intersection point for both the graph when A is greater than 1 and when A is less than 1. So this is how you can visualize. Okay. So now it is clear what is range and what is domain. Once again, this red line, we have made it for all values of x. So domain is once again R, and range is again, there is nothing here. So the range is again R plus. So let's move ahead and go to next graph. Logarithmic functions. Log. Let's say y is equal to log of x base a. So I hope you all remember what are the conditions for log to be defined. This is x greater than 0, a greater than 0, and a should not be equal to 1. If you do not remember them, you are bound to make mistakes. So this is something you must remember every time. So please do not forget them. So let's try and make this graph for y is equal to log of x 2. I hope you have learned how to convert log into exponential. So this goes and this goes like this. That means 2 to the power y is equal to x. I hope you all remember this. Now start putting the values. You have x and you have y. So instead of x, we can put different values of y. So first we will give y is equal to 0. So this gives me 1. If I put y is equal to 1, so this gives me 2. If I put y is equal to 2, this gives me 4. And so on. If I put y is equal to infinity, I get infinity. And if I give 0 plus, I get minus infinity. Okay. So how will the graph look like? You have done it, so I'm sure in class 11. So this is how this looks like. This would be 1, 0. Domain. Now can someone tell me what is domain of this? Please send me the message. And range. Okay. Janvi says domain is R plus. Okay. Right. What about others? It is clear from the graph. You can see what kind of x values it is taking, right? This is your x axis. This is your y axis. This machine is taking some values of x. What are those values? In which quadrant you can see? Janvi says R plus and range is R. Yes, Janvi, you are correct. It is clear. You are taking x values from here to here only. This is only you are taking up, and this is all positive. So 0 to infinity you are taking. Okay, not even 0. And range, you can see this. Range is from minus infinity to plus infinity. The range is your R. Please remember this. This can be seen from the graph. That is why I'm telling you, please make a habit of making these graphs immediately. Just think, okay, what is the graph of a to the power x? So you should be able to draw it immediately. What should be the graph of log x? You should be able to do it immediately. And have you noticed something about, forget about that. Let's see if you can make it. When a is your basis, less than 1. So that means log of x base half. This will means half to the power y equal to x. Please try and make this graph. I'm giving you half a minute to draw this. Please. So I hope you could get it. If not, let's try and do this. Again, the same way. So if I put y equal to 0, what I get? I get 1. If I put y is equal to 1, what I get? Half, right? Let's say I put y is equal to minus 1. What I get is half of the power minus 1. That means I'll get 2. If I put minus 2, I will get 4, and so on. If I put minus infinity, I will get plus infinity. And if I put infinity here, I will get 0 plus. Okay. So my graph would look like something like this. And this would be 1, 0. And here also it is 1, 0. That means this 1, 0 would be the common part. And if I try and the first that we did, that would again, this is how your graph, this is for when your a is greater than 1 or base is greater than 1, and this is when your base is less than 1, but it can so make it 0 to 1. So this is how these two graphs will look like. So you must remember these graphs. They will make your life very easy. And again, domain and range will not change, as you can really see in this graph. Domain is again R plus, and range is your from negative infinity to positive infinity. That means R. So you must remember these things. Once again, I am emphasizing is. Okay. Let's try and do. Now you know the graph of log x or ln x. Okay, ln x, let's say. Ln x, you know the graph. And you know the graph of e to the power x. E to the power x will, this will give you this graph, and e to the power x will come from a to the power x, right? I hope you all can understand that. A to the power x is same because e is 2.7 something, right? So this graph e to the power x would be same as we draw the graph of a to the power x, and ln x would be log of this. So you know the graph. Can you please just make this graph on the same plane? I mean, together, right? Can you please make them graph? Try this. This will actually remind you, okay, how these graphs will look like. Try and do this. And I'll also make this. This is my line. This is e to the power x. And this is ln x. I hope you can make out this. Please tell me yes or no. If you understand them, say yes. Please. This is point is 0, 1 and this is 1, 0. Yes, Amart. Okay. Got it. Aishwarya, a to the power x we did here. I'll show you again. This graph was a to the power x. And in place of a, you can put e because value of e is 2.7 something. So this can be as the graph of e to the power x, not exact values I am putting. I'm just putting you the general graph, right? So this will look a to the power x. And this is your log of x base a. And the ln x for which you know the base is e will also behave in the same way. So these two graph, what I have done is to ask you to draw these graph on the same piece of paper, let's say. Okay, so this is our ln x. You can see the shape and this is our e to the power x, right? I hope you can make out now. Aishwarya, is it clear now? Okay. And this line is y is equal to x. Coordinate mein aapne padha tha कि if there is a line y is equal to x और अगर एक point AB है and if line y is equal to x acts as your mirror, तो what will be the reflection? This would be BA. ये ninth में भी पढ़ा होगा, basically ये ninth या tenth में जो ICSC वाले हैं उन्होंने पढ़ा होगा और बाकी 11th में तो आपने coordinate में पढ़ा ही है line. If line y is equal to x is acting as a mirror, the reflection of is point AB would be BA. I hope you remember that. So now look at here. This is 0, 1 and this is 1, 0. These two points are acting as reflections of each other, right? Okay. Let's say if I put x is equal to 1. So what I get is e. So 1, e. And what about here? This will be e, 1. If x is 1, actually this should be somewhere here, but you can easily make out. So 1e and e 1. So these two graphs. क्या है इंटरचेंज हो रहे एक दूसरे के लिए है ना मिरर इमेज का काम कर रहे हैं दोनों ग्राफ ये एक दूसरे के रिफ्लेक्शंस हैं अराउंड द लाइन y इज इक्वल टू x इजीली लॉग और एक्सपोनेंशियल फंक्शंस एक दूसरे के रिफ्लेक्शंस होते हैं ये ध्यान रखिएगा प्लीज आपसे सीधे सीधे कोई नहीं पूछेगा ऐसी बात लेकिन बट यू शुड हैव दिस इन माइंड कि ओके दीस टू आर रिफ्लेक्शंस ऑफ ईच अदर And this is very clear. And sometimes the knowledge of these graphs actually makes your life very easy when you are doing some questions. JE may be kai bar bahut simple se question aa jaate hain. Kuch is type ka maan lijiye. Let's say I'll give you a question. Okay. How many solutions for log of x base half is equal to x. Can someone tell me how many solutions of this equations are possible? I am not asking exact solutions. Okay. What I am asking is number of solutions. So if you remember the graphs of this, what you can do is you can draw a graph of this we did just now. So this will look like this. And we can treat them separately, right? This graph can be made separately, and y is equal to x. If I take them, y is equal to, so this graph is for log of x base half, and there can be another graph which is y is equal to x. So now you can see these two graphs can intersect only at one place, and that is here. So how many solutions? One only. So this kind of thing, if it is asked and if you remember the graphs, you will be able to solve them within seconds. I hope this is clear to you all now. Now we will move to some questions on domain and range for these. Okay, now you remember what are the domains for these individuals. So we will do some question on that. So I am unmuting you all for a while, and then if you have some questions, we can discuss them. Okay. So let's move ahead. And the question is, find domain of y is equal to root of ln x. Think and tell me. डोमेन मतलब क्या क्या चीजें अलाउड हैं. अच्छा, अब आप ध्यान रखेंगे कि यहां पे अब आपके दो फंक्शंस इन्वॉल्व हो चुके हैं, एक ये स्क्वायर रूट और एक ये एलएन, है ना. तो दोनों की डोमेन्स का इंटरसेक्शन ही लेंगे, ये हमने पिछले लेक्चर में डिस्कस किया था. तो नाउ थिंक एंड टेल मी दी आंसर प्लीज. हाँ जी, चलिए भाई देखें क्या होगा. आपको जैसे ही लॉग है, इसका मतलब क्या हुआ कि लॉग सॉरी स्क्वायर रूट है, तो इसके अंदर की जो भी क्वांटिटी है वो कैसी होनी चाहिए, वो ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू जीरो होनी चाहिए. स्क्वायर रूट डिफाइन ही तभी होगा. तो इसका मतलब ये हो गया कि ln x शुड बी ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू जीरो, राइट. एंड इफ ln x इज ग्रेटर देन जीरो, इसका मतलब क्या होता है, इसका मतलब होता है log ऑफ e बेस x इज ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू जीरो. log ऑफ जब बेस e होता है उसी को तो ln बोलते हैं हम. तो इसका मतलब x इज ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू e टू दी पावर जीरो. अच्छा, अब आपको ये भी ध्यान रहना चाहिए कि ये e जो है वन से ग्रेटर है, और जब बेस वन से ग्रेटर होता है तो इनइक्वालिटी और ग्रेट ये सेम साइड पे ओपन होती है. अगर ये e की जगह मान लीजिए हाफ होता तो ये लेस देन इक्वल टू होता x, ठीक है. आई होप यू नो इट फ्रॉम क्लास 11th. सो x शुड बी ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू e जीरो, e टू द पावर जीरो. एंड e टू द पावर जीरो इज वॉट, greater than equal to 1. तो x हो गया 1। अच्छा अब log के लिए, अब ln x log डिफाइन होने के लिए क्या होना चाहिए x? भाई मैंने आपको log के केस में यहां पे देखो ध्यान से ध्यान देखना, मैंने आपको लिखाया था कि ये if there is a log involved x has to be greater than 0, base has to be greater than 0 and base cannot be equal to 1, ये कंडीशन आपको याद होनी चाहिए थी। So that means x should have been greater than 0, तो ठीक है ये तो हम पे पहले ही आ गया x greater than equal to 1। तो जब मैं इसका और इसका, इसका और इसका इंटरसेक्शन लूंगा, so what will be the answer, यही होगा x greater than equal to 1, that means x belongs to 1 to infinity and this is your domain, this is your domain. I hope this is clear to all of you, please say yes at least. Yo Vikyat and Ritu, yes, okay chaliye, let's move ahead. So another simple question, find domain of 1 over ln x. What will happen? Gurpreet ji, you are asking, will we solve exercises? What kind of exercises, Gurpreet? Which exercises are you talking about? Gurpreet, once we are done with functions, you would have solved at least hundreds of questions, right? And first thing that you should be concerned be about your NCRT, that would be cakewalk for you, I hope, once we are done with this, fine. Those who have completed your first chapter relations, I hope if they would have seen the NCRT, you would be solving all those questions in your mind only. Most of the questions I have already covered for your relations. The same thing will happen. Whatever chapter we pick up, you will, NCRT will become a cakewalk for you. And yes, we will give you additional exercise. So what is the problem, Gurpreet, if this chapter is not started? How does it make a difference? It will come eventually. So it is better for you. You have already done it, right? Okay. What about this? To define this, Vikya says infinity, 2 to infinity, right? Oh, 2 to infinity. Okay, let me see what we get. So to define this, denominator should not be 0. That means ln x should not be 0. That means x should not be e to the power 0. That means x should not be 1. And our condition is what? For log to define, x should be greater than 0. So that means to have this and this together, our domain will become what? R plus minus this elemental one, or we can write this as 0 to 1, right? 0 to 1 union 1 to infinity. So this would be our answer. I hope this is clear to you now. So we have to take care of every function that is being involved, every part, and we have to take the intersection. Say yes or no if it is clear to you. Please tell me quickly. And then I'm moving to the next question. Okay, Amart. Fine. Find domain of root 4x minus x square. Now this should be easy for you. Do it. To define this square root, the quantity under the square root should be greater than or equal to 0. That means 4x minus x square should be greater than or equal to 0. Or we can write this as x square minus 4x should be less than or equal to 0. So this is x minus 4 less than or equal to 0, and when there is less than or equal to 0 involved, your answer is between smaller root and the larger root. So x belongs to 0 to 4. Is it okay? Please say yes or no. Yeah. Aishwarya and Gurpreet, right? So next question. Find domain of log of base x 2x minus 1 and x minus 3. Try this. Okay, let's see. First base. Let's take this base. This x should be greater than 0 and x should not be equal to 1. This was the first condition for the base we wrote. I hope you remember this. If not today, but next in the next class, everyone should be able to recall these conditions for the base. Now conditions for this thing has to be greater than 0. So that means 2x minus 1 into x minus 3 should be greater than 0. And the moment we have this greater inequality, our answer for x is always from minus infinity to smaller root and union greater root to plus infinity. So what will happen? Minus infinity to half union 3 to infinity. this is our answer. So we have to think of now these two conditions we have, and we have to take the intersection of 1 and 2. Can someone tell me what would be the intersection? X should be greater than 0. First thing. Okay, that means yaha se, from here, this will become X will belong to 0 to half. And X should not be equal to 1, so it's fine. 1 is not even included in this. So this should be our answer. Is it clear to you all? Please tell me yes or no. I hope all of you are saying yes then. Yes, Vikrant. Yes, Ritu. Okay. Let's move to one more question. Find domain of e to the power 1 over x. Now, please do it. This is quite simple. For exponential, domain is what? R, yes. For exponential, domain is R. What was the graph of exponential? This, right? So exponential is R. But the only condition is this. That means 1 upon x should also be defined. That means x should not be equal to 0. So we have to take the intersection of this and this. That means our domain would be R minus. We just remove this and then that's the answer. Next question, please. Find domain of log of base 10, log of 10, 1 plus x cube. So now there are two base involved. This is 1 plus x cube. Think about it. So first we have to think, we have this first log and there is some quantity inside. So first, to define this first log, this quantity has to be greater than 0. So that means log of this 10, 1 plus x cube has to be greater than 0. Now this base is already defined because this is 10. So this is clearly defined. So we don't need to look at the base here. Same case here. First thing, this has to be defined. And then this quantity also has to be defined. That means 1 plus x cube has to be greater than 0. So here also we have to write that 1 plus x cube greater than has to be greater than 0. Okay. So first thing this. If this is the situation, so by changing it to exponential, 1 plus x to the power 3 has to be greater than 10 to the power 0. So 1 plus x cube has to be greater than 1 and x cube has to be greater than 0. And for x cube to be greater than 0, what does it mean? That means x should be greater than 0, because if we take x negative, this cube will give you negative value. So x has to be greater than 0. Now what about this? This whole has to be defined x has to be greater than 0. So this is also included in this. So your domain is 0 to infinity. Yeh aapka answer. I hope this is clear. Please tell me if it is clear to you. Say yes or no. Okay, right. Let's move further. Absolute value function or modulus function. You have done it already, I know. In class 11, lots of it has already been dealt. So y is equal to mod of x, and this is defined as x if x is greater than or equal to 0, minus x if x is less than 0. And you all also know the graph of mod x. I know it, so I'm not. So this is your graph of mod x. This is your line y is equal to x, and this is your line y is equal to minus x. And this actually is acting as a mirror, right? So these two are mirror images of each other. So you can clearly see this. What is the domain? Please, what is the domain here? Domain is R. And what is range? Range is all positive. There is nothing in negative side. The range is R plus. I hope this is clear. Okay. Now the question is, find domain and range of y is equal to mod x minus 1. Please try and do this. Okay, let's see. Domain is clearly R because mod is defined for every value of x. So domain is R. Now think about range. Mod gives you positive values, right? And let's think it in other way. X is minus infinity to plus infinity. So this machine mod x minus 1 is taking the value of x as minus infinity to plus infinity. So let's put it there. So minus infinity to infinity I am putting here, and then there is negative 1. So will it make any difference? From minus infinity to minus 1, there will be again minus infinity. Infinity minus 1 is again infinity. So I get minus infinity to infinity. And then there is a positive mod here. So what will this machine do? Now we'll do it. This will again send out what? Only positive numbers. Wait a minute. So that means my output would be 0 to infinity. I hope this is clear. This mod will only throw out positive things. So this would be its range. Okay. What about the graph of this? If I want to know the graph of this. Now, what is happening just try and relate this with coordinate system. We did in the last when we were doing ellipse, parabola and hyperbola, we use these things, right? Transformation of axis. So what will happen? My mod of x looks like this. So instead of x, now my this point will shift to where? Plus one. I hope you can remember from this point would be my 1, 0. Let's try and put x is equal to 1 here. 1 minus 1 is 0. So y is 0. So this point here, let's say this is O. So this will shift to O dash. So this is how this will shift. So this graph will look like this. Okay. Chaliye, next. Find domain and range of y is equal to mod x plus 1. First, think about the graph. How will it look like? You know that the graph of mod x is this. Now what is happening? This y is doing what? It is adding 1 to this mod, right? So what will happen? My graph will move 1 unit above. So this will look like this. Pardon me for not making a straight line, but it is a straight line. Otherwise I'll have to use a scale, which I don't want to, you know. So this will be your y is equal to mod x plus 1. It has shifted to 1 unit above this. So if this graph looks like this, so what is my domain? Domain is obviously from here to here. So domain is obviously R. What is range then? Range would be, now this has shifted to 1, so this will be 1 to infinity. This is clear. Otherwise, you can always think of, okay, y is equal to mod x plus 1 is given. So what is the range of mod x? This is infinity, it has to be open bracket. So 1 plus 1, so it will give me 1 to infinity. So this will become the range. I hope this is clear. Okay, next, find domain and range of y is equal to x plus 1. Remember, we just did before this question x minus 1, right? Here we did x minus 1. This. Now we are doing x plus 1. Just think, what will be the change of the graph? How will it change? Shifting of origin, remember this. So our graph would look like, it will shift to here, right? This will be your minus 1, 0. Rest, nothing will change. So quickly we can say domain is R and range is what? Again, 0 to infinity. So this is your answer. Okay, now if I once again shift a little change, if I'm making to the question, now my function is y is equal to mod of x minus 1 plus 1. How will be the graph look like? We did this x minus 1. So for, let's try and make the graph for x minus 1. X minus 1 was like this. You can check your copy. This was x minus 1, right? Mod of x minus 1 for this graph was for that. And if I add 1 to this, what will happen? This will shift 1 unit up here. Something like this. Okay, so this will look like this. So this graph is for this y is equal to mod of x minus 1 plus 1. Now you can easily think how the shifts are happening, right? And if you will do it again, you will be able to see them more clearly. So what will happen here? So what is domain? Domain, is there any change in domain? No, there is no domain change. What is range? Range is again 1 to infinity. So you can see that. Okay, one last question I would like to take. Find domain and range of y is equal to 1 over mod x. Now, can you tell me, please? Please think about this. Look clearly what will happen. You have to make that mod of x should not be equal to 0. That means x should not be equal to 0. So your domain becomes r minus 0. Now what about range? We have 1 over mod x, and the range for 1 over this is actually 0 to infinity, right? But this 0 should be avoided because x cannot be equal to 0. That means what we will get is 1 over 0 to infinity. And what is 1 over 0 to infinity? This is again 0 to infinity, because 1 over 0 is infinity. And 1 over infinity is 0. So this is our range. I hope these questions are clear. I have taken some very basic, very simple examples, and that should be clear to you. And please do not forget this, because if you miss these, you are going to miss your calculus. So this is all for the day. I hope you had a good session today. Next session will be fruitful only if you can revise everything what we did today. So bye bye for now. See you next time.